Welcome to Control Engineering Playlist. Here in this session, I'll be going to solve example on signal flow graph using Meissen's gain formula. So to have transfer function C by R, we'll be applying Meissen's gain formula to this signal flow graph, and which will result into our answer. And this question was already there in previous year GATE examinations. So let us have first of all what is Meissen's gain formula, and then we will apply it. So C by R, that is what a transfer function, which is summation of fi delta I by delta. Now see here, if you see how many forward paths are there, then there are two forward paths. One is this and second is this. So this formula will be f1 delta 1 plus f2 delta 2 divided by delta. So now we will calculate all those terms which is there in this basic formula, and then we will be having final answer. So first that we need to consider forward paths. So forward path. So we have two forward paths. First is F1, that is this. So that is 2 into 3 into 4 into 1. So that is 2 into 3 into 4. So this is 6 into 4, 20. 4. Now second forward path is this. So that is 1 into 5 into 1. So that is 5. So F2 is 5. Now we need to calculate delta I. So for that we have delta 1 here first. Now what is delta 1? 1 minus loop not touching F1. So if you see first forward path, that is 2 into 4, 2 into 3 into 4. So all loops that is touching to this path. So this will be 1 minus 0, that is 1. Now when you calculate delta 2, so that is 1 minus summation of loop not touching F2. Now this is what the path, right? Now this loop that is not touching to this path. Otherwise this loop is touching, right? So this loop that is not touching to this path, so we can say it is 1 minus, this loop is 3 into minus 1, so minus 3. So 1 minus minus 3, that is plus 3, so that will be 1 plus 3, 4. So delta 2 is 4. Now we need to calculate delta. Now we have F1, F2, delta 1, delta 2. Now we need to calculate delta. So the basic formula of delta is 1 minus single loop, summation of single loop, plus summation of two non-touching loops, minus summation of three non-touching loops. See, that is how it is there. Now here three loops are there, right? So I am directly writing in this formula, 1 minus, first loop is 2 into minus 1 minus 2, second is 3 into minus 1 minus 3, third is 4 into minus 1 minus 4, plus two non-touching loops are minus 2 and minus 4, otherwise all those combinations are touching to each other. So this will be minus 2 into minus 4. So let us simplify this first. So 1 and minus minus will get plus. This is 2, 3, 4. So 5, 9. So plus 9. And this is minus minus plus, plus 6. So if you calculate this, this will be 16. Yes, it is 16. Sorry, it is 8. 2 into 4, that is 8. So this will be 18. Right, it will be 18. Now just apply that to this basic formula. So C by R, C by R, that is transfer function, which is F1, that is 24 into 1 delta 1, and plus F2 into delta 2, F2 is 5 into delta 2, that is 4, divided by delta, that is 18. So now you'll be finding this will be 24 plus 20, so 44 divided by 18. I think I have done some mistake here. Let me check it again. Yes, I forgot one loop actually. You can see one loop. See, this is how you will be making mistake. The reason is I must have forgot one loop. So see, this is one loop, 5 into minus 1 minus 1 minus 1. So this loop that I have forgot. So minus 5, this one loop. So minus 5 that I need to add here. See, this is how students are making mistakes, right? So I need to show it, I need to address it. So plus 5, so that will be 23. So this will be 23 now. So when you see this answer, that will be now 44 by 23. I hope that you have understood this. This kind of small mistakes that we used to do in exam. So we need to take care of this when you solve this problem. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that you have understood this session. In future, I'll make videos to sort out all those queries which is there with you. Thank you so much for watching this video.